يعطيكم العافية. بدنا نبلش نكمل مندلي انهيرتنس. محاضرة اليوم شبيهة محاضرة المرة الماضية، لكنه الاختلاف انه اسم مندلي انهيرتنس is located on the sex chromosome. So this is the sex-linked disorders. Sex-linked genes are genes located on the X chromosomes. More than 100 sex-linked genetic disorders have been linked to the X chromosome. Y chromosomes is much smaller, حكينا, and contains only a few genes. The male have only one X chromosome, and all alleles on the X chromosome are expressed in males, even if they are recessive. شو يعني؟ يعني بما انه الميل عنده X و Y ما عنده باربادي، ما عنده انه ريسيسيف اي جينز ذات ار، مثلا عنده اكس ثاني ك هيومن ميل طبيعي، فما راح يكون عنده غير واحد اكس كروموسومز. فكل الاليلز، كل الجينز الموجودين على الاكس كروموسوم تبعينه they will be expressed. طبعا هاي المعلومه كثير مهمه لما نحكي عن هلا السكس لينك ديزيزز. سو هذا بالنسبه للسكس لينك جينز. Chromosomal X chromosomes inheritance. X chromosome 5% of the human genome, approximately 160 million base pairs, are located on the X chromosome. More than 700 genes are identified. Most of them are recessive and a few are dominant. مثلا أشياء، مثلا طلع على ال X chromosome عندنا الأشياء المعروفة. Hemophilia A and B are located on the X chromosome. They are X-linked. Fragile X syndrome. هنحكي عنها. A lot of other blood disorders, مثلا G6PD deficiency, drug sensitive anemia, chronic hemolytic anemia, color blindness is also linked to the X chromosome. شو في أشياء كمان ممكن تعرفوها؟ I think that's the major things. And Hunter syndrome, I think you probably know this one as well. So هاي هي بتحكي لك أشياء ال usually these are from the common illnesses that are linked to the X chromosome. X-linked disorders, males are at risk. This is what we were trying to say. In no, a normal father, XY, with a normal with a carrier mother, XX. So the if the ovum is carrying the affected X chromosome. Now, if the both outcomes are abnormal, يعني إذا طلع male راح يكون affected male، إذا طلع female راح تكون carrier female. هلا إذا الأوفم فياتها the normal X, this will always give you a normal outcome, a normal male or a normal female. فهي نطلع هون مرة تانية. This is the X affected X. Now, if this should make a female with the mate with the normal father, this would be a carrier female. Then the abnormal X, if it is fertilized by the Y of the father, we have an affected male. Now, can a carrier mother give an affected female? ما في شيء. X-linked, dominant. Recessive. This is why this is part of the Mendelian disorders, because X-linked can be dominant or recessive. Affected males will produce all affected daughters dominant, but no affected sons. And this is X-linked dominant disorders. 50% chance that a heterozygous affected female will pass traits to either son or daughter. خلينا نحكي على الأولى أول شيء. Affected males will produce all affected daughters, but no affected sons. توقع هلا في صورة هلا بوجيكم إياها. So a male that has an X-linked dominant disorders, يعني disorder, يعني عنده the dominant allele. This dominant allele, if it is dominant allele, if it is given to a daughter, بما إنها dominant, all the daughters will have the disease. No affected sons, because his sons will not carry his X chromosome. So all his sons will be not affected. هلا 50% شانس الهيتروزايغس افكتد فيميل، اذا كانت الفيميل افكتد ان كانت هيتروزايغس يعني عندها واحد اكس طبيعي واحد اكس مش طبيعي، 50% شانس will pass the trait to either son or daughter يعني نسبة متساوية، لأنه يا بتعطي الإكس لابن يا بتعطي الإكس لبنت، بغض النظر رح يكون اثنيناتهم affected because this is a dominant disease. Homozygous females pass trait on all to the all their offspring. On average, twice as many females affected as males because هون بالX being dominant اللي عنده أكثر X رح يكون عنده أكثر more likely to have to be affected، بما إنه إذا عندك هالX رح you'll be affected. Females are twice as likely to be affected. Expressed with in females with one copy بما إنه dominant، إذا عندك one copy you will still be expressed. Males are often more severely affected بأنه لا إنه ما عندهم another they cannot be heterozygous they will be more affected or more severely affected. كمان typically associated with miscarriage or lethality in males. X-linked dominant طلع مثلا هاي الفاميلي تري in the first generation كان الأب affected، so هذا الأب واحد بده يتذكر انه حيكون عنده X affected والواي طبيعية. اتزوج هلا اعطى هاي الاكس لكل بناته، طبعا ما رح يعطي الاكس تبعته للاولاد، فابنه هذا ما معه، عنده ثلاث بنات وهدول الثلاث بنات عندهم. هلا بدنا نكمل، هذا الابن اتزوج كل عيلته كل his progeny طبيعيين ما عندهم اشي لانهم did not carry the affected or affected X chromosome. هلا البنت هاي اتزوجت، هلا طلع شو الناتج من هالزواج، عندها اكس افكتد مش طبيعية، اعطته لنص اولادها زي ما حكينا لنص الاولاد obviously she is heterozygous، فاعطت هاي الاكس اخذت اكس من عندها واي من الاب، عندها اكس واي افكتد ميل another اكس واي افكتد ميل، اخذت اكس من الاب والاكس تبعها عملت affected female. الاكس الثانية الطبيعية عملت normal male normal female another normal female so 50% were affected. راح يكون هون عندك نفس الاشي هون another the same الحالة نفسها بتنعاد مرة تانية. So هاي الصورة اللي حبينا نوصل لها X-linked dominant inheritance an X-linked dominant affected father so this is an affected father عنده الX chromosome carries this هاي لونها أحمر carries this gene that is dominantly expressed. فرح يعطي زي ما حكينا الأب رح يعطي لكل بناته، إذا كان الميل affected رح يأخذ X X من هنا طبع هالبنت أو ال X هاي مع ال X هاي رح تعطي البنت الثانية، فكل بناته رح يكونوا affected. أولاده رح يعطي ال Y هو بس ال Y ما فيها إشي، مع ال unaffected mother all his children or his عفوا all his sons all his male son male children are unaffected. هلا بالاكس الاكس لينك دومينانت اذا كانت المذر افكتد فهون الافكتد عندها واحد اكس كروموسوم، اجين يا هذا الاكس كروموسوم مع هذا الاكس كروموسوم يو هاف ان افكتد دوتر، يا هذا الاكس كروموسوم مع هذا الاكس كروموسوم يو هاف ان ان افكتد دوتر، يا هالاكس مع هذا الواي بتعطيك افكتد سن، او هاي الاكس my high why you have an unaffected son. So this is the 50% that we were mentioning. So 50% were affected. X-linked dominant inheritance. There are a very few X-linked dominant traits. Dwarfing conditions due to X-linked dominant condition include another form of chondrodysplasia punctata, X-linked dominant type, incontinentia pigmenti, congenital generalized hypertrichosis. Are X-linked also hypophosphatemic vitamin D resistant rickets. So this is congenital generalized hypertrichosis. A lot of hair everywhere. This is an X-linked dominant hypophosphatemic or the vitamin D resistant rickets as well. Both high incontinentia pigmenti are X-linked. Dominant trait heterozygous female pigment swirls on the skin زي ما شايفين الصورة تحت هنا hair and tooth loss seizures males, they are usually dying in youth as it is more severe, and no homozygous females because it's also no males can reproduce because all males die in utero. X-linked dominant examples: ichthyosis, deficiency of an enzyme that removes cholesterol from the skin, so you have the cholesterol deposits in the skin, and you have this cracked shiny skin. Congenital bilateral ptosis, like this, is also droopy eyelids, zygeica. Also, this is an X-linked dominant condition. هل X-linked recessive disorders affects homozygous males and homozygous females. يعني إيش؟ الميلز راح يكون كلهم راح يكون homozygous with X. So all the males, if they have it, they will be affected. And only females when they have both X chromosomes will they have. معناته هنا صار إن الميلز more likely to be affected rather than females. بعكس X-linked dominant disorders. Expressed phenotype much more common in males زي ما حكينا. اللي هو الفينوتايب احنا بنحكي هنا affected يعني مش انه وجود الاكس كروموسوم لانه راح يكون كثير في كارير فيميلز بس احنا نحكي عن الاكسبرس فينوتايب يعني affected people are more likely to be males. Affected males get the mutant allele from their mothers. Obviously they get it from their mother because they are only getting the Y from their fathers. Affected males transmit the mutant allele to all their daughters. Obviously, they will only have their X, his X from them. So, this affected male will give all his daughter the chromosome, the affected chromosome. هلا إذا تزوج carrier female, this is where you can get an affected female, or you can have a carrier female. But obviously, an affected male will not be carrying, will not be transmitting it to his male children. Daughters of affected males are usually heterozygous, thus unaffected. فان affected male ما رح يعطي لأولاده ورح يعمل كل بناته رح يصيروا are usually carriers. Sons of heterozygous mothers have a 50% chance of being affected. إذا كانت المذر is heterozygous carrier فطبعا هي نص الاحتمال نص انها تعطي ال X chromosome لواحد من أولادها ف 50% من الأولاد رح يكونوا affected 50% من البنات راح يكونوا carriers. Abnormal disorder causing allele is recessive and is located located on the X chromosome. طبعا تمام. Affects homozygous males and homozygous females زي ما حكينا. There's nothing new here. I think this is just a repetitive. So normal wild type allele normal wild type allele is dominant. خلينا نرجع نكمل هنا. Okay, so X-linked recessive inheritance. So this is recessive. Now an affected father, هيو. He's affected. عنده X chromosome. راح يتزوج with an unaffected mother. إذا this affected father أعطى هاي الX لواحدة من بناته, she will be a carrier daughter. أعطى هاي الX للبنت الثانية, also a carrier daughter. So any of his daughters normal? No, all of them are carriers. All of them are genotypically abnormal, phenotypically normal. أعطى هالواي تبعته ما مالها إشي. All his sons are normal. So affected father cannot transmit to sons, but can make all carrier daughters. تمام. هلا إذا كانت المشكلة عند المذر, she was phenotypically normal, genotypically a carrier. أعطت هالX high لوحدة من البنات, she was a carrier daughter. أعطت هالX high لوحدة من الأولاد, he was an affected son, so this is the phenotype we'll show here. عند الX الثانية, normal son. And normal daughter. X-linked this recessive if the mother is affected. طيب إذا the mother is a homozygous, راح تعطي هاي يا بتعطي الإكس هذا لا affected male بصير معك, بتعطي هذا الاكس لهنا كارير فيميل، بتعطي الاكس هذا للواي افكتد سن، بتعطي الاكس هاي لهاي الاكس. So all of them are abnormal. All of the daughters are carriers. All of the sons are affected. How do you get an affected mother? زي ما حكينا. If an affected mother marries an affected father. فراح يحط الاكس تبعته هاي مع اكس هذا راح تطلع لك من affected mother. X-linked recessive. So an unaffected female carrier. خلينا نشوف طلع كيف. An unaffected female carrier. زي ما حكينا كل اولادها بصير معهم. البنات كلهم carriers. هذا الولد زي ما حكينا راح يعطي لنص بناته او هذا عفوا راح يعطي لكل بناته اللي بصيروا carrier. So we have another carrier. So as if you skipped a generation. The fourth generation راح يصيروا say second generation, you will have the sons are affected and the هنا يعني صدفت انه the sons are affected and that's how it is. من هون you have a carrier daughter, an affected son, again no affected females, and then two carrier daughters. So as we can see, all daughters are carriers and all sons are affected. X-linked recessive inheritance. Pitfalls in recognizing, زي ما حكينا هذا كنا نحكي المحاضرة الماضية. Pitfalls in recognizing these kind of inheritance. Small families, small family size and few male children may make the pattern of an X-linked recessive disorder difficult to diagnose. إذا ما عندهم أولاد وعندهم كثير بنات وكل البنات are carriers والأم carrier مثلا أو هذا ما ببين عندهم. إذا كان الأب عنده وكل عندهم بنات again no phenotype is showing. ف small families can mask this effect. Again زي بالبقية new mutation germline mosaicism an affected male may be the first person in the family with the condition due to a mutation arising for the first time sperm or ova or the embryo. Germline mosaicism, زي ما حكينا, a new mutation may arise in the testes or the ovaries resulting in a parent who can pass on the condition without having the condition himself or the carrier state مثلا للأولاد without being either affected or a carrier. So germline mosaicism can happen in a male or a female obviously, so you will have either ما عنده symptoms and then he was transmitting the mutation. X-linked recessive disorders, شو أمثلة عليها؟ Again, من الأشياء كنا نحكي عنها G6PD, hemophilia A and B. برجيناكم أشياء تانية. بس الأشياء كتير مهمة تحت طلعوا the muscular dystrophies. So, retinitis pigmentosa, ocular albinism, هذول كنا أشياء بتعرفوها, Hunter syndrome, Lishnihan, and the muscular Duchenne, Becker, and the muscular other muscular dystrophies. كل هدول are X-linked recessive. Ocular albinism, Hunter syndrome, hemophilia A and B, G6PD. هدول كلهم تعرفوهم. Color blindness as well. Adrenal leukodystrophy. I don't know if you know it, but this is obviously just an atrophy of the adrenal gland. Hemophilia. إذا تتذكروا حكينا بأول محاضرة إنه كيف لما كنا نحكي عن كيف العائلات الأوروبية العائلات الحاكمة الأوروبية كان عندهم هيموفيليا ماشية. فكل الفيميلز are carriers وبصير عندهم عند الميلز is affected. So فكل الفيميل a lot of the females were carriers and a lot of the kings that or a lot of the males in these dynasties were affected. And that obviously was a problematic thing. Hala Y-linked traits. The Y chromosome is small and does not contain many genes. Tamam. Y-linked diseases are very rare, only passed from father to son. An example is male infertility, hairs on ears, hypertrichosis pinnae. Those are some examples that you can. How can you transmit male infertility? We will talk about it, but infertility هنا يعني can be a bit relative, but مع التكنيكس الموجودة حاليا it can be transmitted, يعني إذا مستخدم IVF مثلا لهم وما إلى ذلك. So Y chromosomes, chromosome is about only 70 mega base pairs. Few dozen genes are found in the Y chromosome. Male differentiation genes. مش محطوط هنا. لا محطوط هيو الـ SRY. This is the male differentiation gene. Testis specific spermatogenesis factor. So you have to have it to have normal spermatogenesis. Minor histocompatibility gene. ذكر حكينا بالاميونو and several housekeeping genes transmission strictly from father to son. So you cannot have these as genes that females cannot live without, obviously. لأنه the females will not have all these. تخيل أنت ما عندها ما عندها مش مهم ال female عندها spermatogenesis factor, male differentiation genes, very minor histocompatibility genes and so on. Hypertrichosis pinni مثلا, this is an Y linked. فتخيل يعني حكون الأب رح يعطي لكل أولاده. فزي ما احنا شايفين هذا الأب عنده hypertrichosis pinni, hairy ears, أعطى لكل أولاده دول الثلاثة, عنده بنت ما عندها إياه. هذا الولد تزوج أعطى لكل أولاده, عنده بنت ما عندها إياه. هذا الولد كمان تزوج أعطى لأولاده, هذا الولد تزوج أعطى لأولاده. So it all runs in the only strictly in the Y chromosome, so only in the males. The Y chromosome serves as a paternal marker through history. إذا بدك تعرف زي ما حكينا مثلا إنه بدنا نعرف البروجيني الماركر لل مثلا اختبار الأبوة مثلا. So this is the Y chromosome will serve as the paternal marker through through this. So DNA mutation and the Y chromosome serve as markers for the male lineage. مثلا لأن بما إنه صغير الواي كروموسوم نقدر نعمله سيكونس لجيناته, نقدر نعرف هذا الميتيشن مثلا طلع عند هنا إنه هذا أب فلان وهذا راح يكون مثلا أب فلان وهذا أب هذا وهذا أب. نقدر نعمل نعرف الباترنالتي through these small subtle single nucleotide polymorphisms موجودين بالواي كروموسوم عند البعض. فنقدر نعرف إنه هذا مثلا طلع كثير في لون خفيف, هذا خلف أولاده وهيهم هذا حطلع زيه بالضبط, واحد عنده شوية بوليمورفيزم اختلاف, واحد طلع عنده زيه بالضبط. فهذا بنقدر نعرف أولاده كلهم عندهم نفس الباترن هذا, نقدر نعرف هذا مثلا إنه فلان هذول نفس الشيء. فهذا طلع تزوج بنته عنده لونه برتقالي, فطلع كل أولاده عندهم برتقالي, فنقدر نعرف الأولاد هذولا مثلا ابن هذا وهذا ابن هذا مثلا. This is what we're trying to get at. Known genes of the Y chromosomes. SRY is the sex region of the Y chromosome. ZFI is zinc finger protein. AZY is your sperm. AZY means azoospermia. This is responsible for the development of the sperm. HY cell surface antigen present on each cell of four males only. MSY long palindromic sequence of the Q arm of the Y chromosome. Y-linked traits related to genes unique to the Y chromosome are present only in males, passed directly from fathers to sons. Hemizygous, always expressed. Very rare, only about 36 Y-linked traits are known. One important gene, Y-linked traits not only often associated with infertility. One important gene, this is determining factor, also known as SRY, sex determining region of the Y chromosome. For sex chromosomes, determine gender, diploid germ cells in female, and the Y chromosome. So the Y chromosome, the sperm determines the gender, so the sex chromosome determine are determined. Defining sex, chromosomal sex, gonadal sex, phenotypic sex, and formation of male or female reproductive structures depends on the gene action, interaction within the embryo, and interactions with other embryos in the uterus, interactions with the maternal environment as well. Mutations that alter phenotypic sex. هذا mutation في عندي راح يغير الفينوتايب تبع السكس. هذا المهم، هذه نقطة من المحاضرة كتير مهمة. هلا راح نحكي عن the phenotype of sex. So hermaphrodites have both male and female gonads. Can this happen? Yes, you can have a true hermaphrodite where they have both male and female gonads. Androgen insensitivity. So XY males become phenotypic females. هنا androgen insensitivity يعني عندك male who is normal XY but his cells are insensitive to an androgen. ما بتجاوبوا له. They do not change the phenotype, so they remain as during in utero they remain as a phenotype female. بما مع إنه is an XY male. So فهو genotype male, phenotype female. الهرمافروديت عنده phenotype is ambiguous, مش معروف هل هو male ولا female. وهلا بنحكي عن الجينوتايب. Pseudo hermaphroditism, XY males at birth are phenotypically female. At puberty they start developing male phenotype. Pseudo hermaphrodites have either ovaries or testes combined with the opposite genitalia. هاي القواعد عشان نعرفها. Pseudo hermaphrodite have either ovary or testes. يعني يا عنده يا ovary يا testes combined with the opposite genitalia. يعني عنده إذا عنده ovary راح يكون عنده male genitalia. إذا عنده testes راح يكون عنده female genitalia. This is the pseudo hermaphrodites. True hermaphrodites have an ovary and a testes. Or a combined gonad called the ovotestes. So, هي ال هنا مثلاً راح يكون هذا. This is I think this is the true hermaphrodite. هي عنده هنا ovary, oo-testes, and عنده يا عنده ovotestes اللي هو هذا يكونوا مع بعض. So this is a true hermaphrodite. This is a pseudo hermaphrodite. عنده مثلاً and male genitalia and with ovaries مثلا. So هاي يعني just more expansion on it. Pseudo hermaphrodite gonad and chromosome X is consistent but external genitalia is opposite. So male normal testes 46XY, incomplete masculinization of the Wolfian duct, external genitalia راح يكون female. This is pseudo hermaphroditism. Female normal ovaries 46XX, partially masculine body, masculinized external genitalia, enlarged clitoris, excess facial hair, infertility, irregular periods. If male راح يكون normal development. فهذا راح يكون عندك الفينوتايب الجينيتاليا الفينوتايب تبعهم. حتى الفينوتايب يعني تبع الميل او الفيميل راح يكون more on the opposite مع انه the gonads are normal, بس opposite زي ما حكينا. So complete androgen insensitivity syndrome طلع هنا مثلا. This is androgen insensitivity syndrome complete. So the phenotype, the genotype is male, the phenotype is female. Female body hair pattern, breast development, and descendant testes, no fallopian tubes, uterus, no epididymis. طبعا ما فيش ولا من ال structures تبعين male genitalia, infertile, no menstruation, female gender identity. But they identify as females. Partial androgen sensitivity, فطلع من طلع عليه is sparse body hair, some breast development. So small penis, hypospadias بيكون مثلا opening تبع اليوترس تبع اليوريتر بيكون alongside the urethra. عفوا the urethra. So بيكون opening sometimes is below the normal. Small scrotum, subfertility, sexual dysfunction, male or female, a gender identity. فبتلاقي هون more ambiguous. تمام. through hermaphroditism, ovary plus testes are present, or an ovotestes. رح يكون عنده both gonads. This is the true hermaphrodite. Have both gonads. They are both present. They can be bilateral ovotestes or unilateral ovotestes with the other side normal, or testes in one side, ovary on the other side. Location is uncertain. أحيانا بما إنه testes descends some so جزء ما تكون من مكانها. But clinically is present. Significant gynecomastia is present. طبعا 75% منهم. 50% menstruate. If male, phenotype present as cyclic hematuria. تخيل male who has cyclic hematuria because they have 50% of them, they have ovary aura, ovo testes. Primary pseudo autosomal region. These regions pair and combine and recombine during meiosis and thus are not truly sex linked. So secondary pseudo autosomal region. So خلينا نحكي عنها. So this gene Y is linked because it is found only on the Y chromosome. So شو بصير إذا هذا الجين طلع من هاي المنطقة؟ فراح يصير this Y chromosome will not confer the male phenotype. Organization of human sex chromosomes. Many genes escape inactivation. X chromosome inactivation center. خلينا نحكي هلا شوية قدام. Sequence homologies of XY chromosomes. So 15% of the X chromosome escape inactivation. احنا قاعدين نحكي عن inactivation of the X chromosome. So tips of the P and Q arm escape inactivation. Steroid sulfatase, metabolism of steroids is present on the X chromosome. XG blood group also present on the X chromosome as well, and many housekeeping genes. PR regions are pseudo-autosomal regions. They never get inactive. Telomeric position on the two sex chromosomes. The pseudo-autosomal region 1 is 2.6 megabase pair, and the second one is 320 kilobase pair. Provide choice of partial meiotic pairing and obligatory crossing over in PAR 1. فهنا موجودة هاي. هلا بنقلل الصورة بتوضح كل شيء. مثلا XG blood group. This is the male determining region SRY on the Y chromosome. فإذا عندك pseudo autosomal region هنا موجودة. And this is the X specific area. This is the pseudo autosomal region that does not get activated. فال SRY region is very close to it on the Y chromosome. And the rest is the Y. So بالطبيعي هاي ال Y بده يجي مع هذه ال X. This Y carries the SRY. And then you will have a normal male. So this is homologous pairing. So شو بصير إذا هاي الأوتوسومال region that is not supposed to happen? What happens if crossing over happens and the SRY is now abnormally transmitted into the X chromosome? So the X chromosome now starts to confer the male phenotype. So you have X chromosome. If this goes with another X, so you have XX males. هون إذا هذا ال Y راح عمل مع X, but you have an XY female. Sex-limited autosomal genes affects a structural process behavior found only in one sex due to anatomical differences. حكينا هاد زي مثلا إشي باليوترس, إشي بالتستيز, إشي بالmale gonads or the female gonad. Encoded on autosomal genes but expressed in one sex, إذا كان إذا إشي that affects the uterus وكانت female, it will show. إذا هذا something that is expressed in the uterus and طلع عند ميم عند male, راح يكون zero penetrance عند الميل, بما إنه الميل ما عنده uterus at all مثلا. هذا هي كلها sex limited idea. Sex influenced autosomal genes, مثلا baldness dominant in males and recessive in females. بتلاقي حتى females لما يكبروا مثلا بخف شعرهم شوية, بس they don't have the baldness that the males have. So this is XX influence. It is more dominant in one gender over the other. آخر إشي X chromosome inactivation. نذكر كنا نحكي عن الionization, حكينا راح نشرحها. But this is where it is. So this is proposed by Mary Leon and Lyon Russell in 1961, saying that if you have two X chromosomes, you will inactivate one of them, and obviously in the male, there is no inactivation. So a normal female will have one bar body. So inactivation of the X chromosome takes place randomly in the early phase of development in a healthy female. يعني randomly ايش يعني؟ There is no predicting in no, this allele will always be inactivated بال, مثلا بالبروجيني تبع الفيميل الفلانية. Or this X chromosome is always inactivated. This happens random and it happens in the early phase of development. يعني حتى بالإمبريو, خلال الإمبريو, this is early on, some cells randomly inactivate one of their X chromosomes. The same X chromosome gets inactive in the offspring generation of cells. بمعنى إذا الخلية الفلانية early on inactivated X chromosome A بدل B, كل أولادها كل الخلايا اللي بطلعوا منها they will have the same X chromosome also inactivated. Early in the development of female, one X chromosome is inactivated at random 7 to 10 days after fertilization, the zygote around 24 cells. Virtually all genes of the X chromosome turn into inactive phase except genes responsible for the inactivation. طبعا females are mosaic for inactive X chromosome. طبعا عندهم يا A, XA is inactivated بعض الخلايا وبعض الخلايا XB is inactivated. So هذا هو mosaic form عندهم. And paternal X chromosome gets inactive too. مثلا G6PD in heterozygous females have normal blood cells and abnormal ones. مثلا حكينا مش G6PD is مثلا is X-linked as well. فراح تكون إذا راح يكون بعض الخلايا عندها إذا كان one of the alleles is problematic فراح يكون بعض الخلايا فيهم G6PD وبعض الخلايا ما فيش فيهم G6PD. So this is the effect of this inactivation of the X chromosome. This is where the mosaicism can happen. Male constitutional hemizygotes, obviously, and female are functional hemizygotes. Sequence homologies of the X and Y chromosomes, 15% of X chromosome escape inactivation. Types of P and Q arm escape inactivation. Steroid sulfatase, so this is one of the enzymes that is needed for this process. The XG blood group Kallmann syndrome, half-scaping genes, حكيناها معيودة هنا. X inactivation, the Lyon hypothesis states that one X chromosome in the cell is randomly inactivated. Inactivation results in dosage compensation, same amount of gene produced products of X chromosome is present. هاي زي ما حكينا مثلا هاي الزيغوت, early cleavage. هون ال XP is موجود وال XM صار بار بادي. فهون كل خلاياها صارت XP, كل أولادها صارت XP. هون مثلا ال XM صار موجود وال XP صار inactive, صار بار بادي. فهون كلهم البار بادي عندهم ال XP مثلا, وهون بالعكس وهون بالعكس, وهكذا بصير عندك خلايا الجسم موزايك. بعضهم عندهم ال XP is exposed is being is the dominant is the expressed allele, والثاني is bar body, ونص الخلايا الثانية بالعكس. The X activation center is located in XQ13, the X the or the XIST, the ZEST X inactive specific transcript. The gene is transcribed only from the inactive X chromosome, so the inactive one transcribes its own inactivation. So mechanism of the X chromosome inactivation, XIC inactivation controls expression of the XIST gene. The XIC gene transcribes itself and produces a non-coding molecule, coats the entire chromosome and becomes a bar body. فهي هون الطريقة, ما بدناش نحكي عنها كتير أكثر من هيك, إنه هي الجين becomes expressed, produces protein, the protein inhibits and spreads and coats the entire one. Entire X chromosome. Transcription becomes silenced, and there is an increased hypoactylated. يعني خلاص, that's all we want to know. And it becomes inactive. Mosaicism reveals the random inactivation of one X chromosome. So calico cat fur, مثلا هنا, this is an X-linked thing, so I can show you the mosaicism here. So مثلا هنا هاي skin disorder and hydrotic ectodermal dysplasia. You have portions of unaffected skin زي الكات. Unaffected skin, X chromosome with the recessive allele was condensed. Its allele is inactive. فهنا normal skin مثلا الأصفر هذا مثلا this is normal skin مثلا. أو عفوا ال normal skin. هنا الأصفر is affected. So affected skin with no normal sweat glands in this tissue. The X chromosome with the dominant allele has been condensed. So the recessive allele on the other X chromosome is now being transcribed. فبطلع معك this recessive problem on the partial, on certain parts of the skin. زي ال fur color in cats. So some skin is normal, some skin is abnormal, depending on the mosaicism. ويعطيكم العافية. بنكمل نبعثكم إن شاء الله المحاضرة الأسبوع القادم بوقتها إن شاء الله.